We got some more MHA today, and well, I think what we're probably gonna get is like Momo and the squad versus Gigantomachia, possibly, which would be insane. I mean, they've shown us so much that the pros are like, you know, at this high level compared to UA students. So it's kind of hard to see how, like, you know, the UA students will have a chance against Gigantomachia when none of the pros can handle it, you know? Like, the villains couldn't even handle Gigantomachia. Gigantomachia is only on their side because they avoided him for long enough that he got to see how cool Shigaraki was, you know? But they weren't beating him in a one-on-one fight. He is insane. Now, his weaknesses, obviously, would be, like, he's very one-minded, you know, short-sighted. He has one goal in mind and just goes towards it at full speed, so he's not necessarily going to be attacking them. But there are the League of Villains on his back, so they might be attacking the UA students. I don't know. If that is how what we're doing this episode, if we are actually having like Momo in the squad versus the, you know, this Gigantomachia in the squad, I'm a little scared, but let's just get into this episode. If you enjoy these, please support the videos and go to my Patreon account for full length early access exclusive videos, all that sort of stuff. Anyway, let's get into this episode of My Hero Academia. Here we go.
Together as one, we'll take down this villain.
Yeah, all right, I'm keen, let's do it.
That means it's likely the League is with him. They may be on his back. According to Ms. Midnight. But given his size, I estimate we need to pump at least 30 liters in him.
Oh, Kodai is there, the size girl.
An injection is impossible. We administer the drug orally.
Oh my god, okay.
These jars contain undiluted doses that should be enough to knock him out.
Each
so
one?
Get one in his mouth, and that'll do it?
Mm-hmm. We'll set up a trap for him.
I guess if it's, I guess down, that's a lot in. Of tranquilizer. Like that much is a lot.
Okay.
Midnight. There's no way she'd let those losers kill her.
I'm not sure.
I'm sure she's fine.
Whoa, what are these?
She'll be teaching us cool stuff before you know it.
Oh.
Could conserve some energy just in case.
Dynamite?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Yikes!
Uh-oh. Okay, alright! Oh, and the League are falling off! Oh, that's terrifying. Oh my god. Oh my god! those are your three strongest. Isn't Kirishima strong enough for this, maybe?
Hey, we're the ones at a disadvantage.
Oh, nice, man. They got some good restraining techniques. Oh. Come on, shove some donuts in that guy's mouth. No! Oh, Toga's still out of it a bit. I was thinking she was uncharacteristic, but I forgot Twice just died. Oh. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh, that's- oh, poltergeisting them onto- that's a great plan! Oh no. Oh, he's got more rubble.
Just run! Go to sleep!
We can't let this monster get to the city!
Oh, that's risky. Oh no! Oh my god.
Gotta love your quirk that converts morale into physical energy. And the one that keeps you from feeling pain.
Whoa.
And there's more, of course. It shows powers that let you stay on the battlefield as long as possible.
Oh my god.
Which makes you a perfectly engineered bodyguard.
Dang, that's hot. The fire is blocking us.
Okay, alright, there seems the dynamite. Alright, she had more of a plan.
If we bury him deeper, maybe we'll take him.
I think you should have used Kodai to grow the bombs to even bigger, right? Ah, if that still works.
Here's the king of burrowing.
I don't know exactly how it works.
He's like a big mole.
Hey, is this really time for chit chat? Look.
Oh, nice. Oh my god. Yeah, Mountain Lady. Come on. Oh my god.
They're damn smart.
Mina? Whoa!
You got this!
What is that? What was that? That's awesome! Whoa, that said Creati with a Y. I thought it was Creati with an I. Did they change it? Did they retcon what her name
is? Is everyone okay?
Oh my god, Mina, what is this? It's like a barrel?
Gooey armor, the heat won't be a problem for me. I got this.
Oh my god, Mina.
You fight through it.
Come on. Oh no, oh no. Oh, I'm scared.
Yes, I will not let them swarm me again.
Oh no.
Everything is for my master.
Oh, are you going to recognize him from... You're gonna recognize it from your backstory, of course! I've completely forgot! You were terrified of him! Oh. Oh my god! Oh no! Oh! Oh, Mina! Oh my god. Kirishima! Holy shit! Oh yeah! He made up for it by getting him away! Oh, that's amazing!
I can't! He needs help!
The dumb punk. Oh, I can't believe he rushed in faster!
God! Oh my god.
Think again!
Oh my god, Kirishima. You still caught Mina's. Oh! I think that got in! Yeah! Okay, so you're smothering the flames. Alright.
Now, heroes! We can't rely on the work study students to do all the work.
Okay.
I won't waste any more time on them.
Whoa! What?
Hold on! Crazy! How many powers does he have?
What the hell? Oh my god! Oh, that's what my father his father said. Yeah.
While you took advantage of these so-called victims for your own profit, everything that I've ever known.
You're knocking at death's door, aren't you? That's good.
Oh my god. Oh, look how
is he still moving?
Insane he looks. I liked that monologue.
Endeavor's firepower has grown weaker, passing his limits to fight.
Oh.
Without quirks.
Ah.
What a terrible face.
Oh. Oh my god.
He'll use my kid against us.
It's too late, he did.
I no longer have a son.
Oh my god.
I'm not a mother anymore, Sorohiko.
Did we make the right choice?
You didn't. Which. Oh. Jesus! This. Oh no. Oh no. Going right to Eraser, yeah. Oh no, are you using a quirk erasing bullet on him? Is that what you're gonna use?
To move.
Oh!
Naraki!
Oh!
Into power! Keep him bound!
Oh my god. Oh my god! Controlling your emotions, so Black Whip works with you.
Hold! Hold! Muster your strength.
Oh no. Oh no.
These fools still don't know I have this.
Oh no!
Deleter! That's the thing that stole Togeta's
quirk! Oh, I know.
No! 100%!
100%! Oh my god. Did he just take a 100% hit quirkless? Did he bite his arm?
Right now.
He bit his arm!
Feels though I can overcome anything standing in my way where I came from.
Oh my god. Oh my god!
Eraser!
Oh my god. Oh my god! Holy shit! That is an insane episode. I think I screamed more at some of the things that happened in that episode than I've done in a while in any show, really. I'm just very attached to MHA. I mean, I think it's pretty clear from this. I mean, MHA is the series that got me to really, really care about anime. I watched anime before MHA, like a little bit, but like my entire intention for watching as much anime as I do was to find something that gave me the same feeling as MHA. I know that, like, people have their problems with the series. Some people don't like the popularity of it. Some people don't like the fan base. Some people think that, you know, the show's overrated or whatever. All cards on the table. The words underrated and overrated, I hate those words. I think they're terrible words for reviewing media, for telling how you feel, because they tell me basically nothing about the quality of the media, but rather your opinions on what other people think about the media, and I don't think that's a great way to talk about things. So I think when someone says, like, oh, MHA is overrated, that tells me nothing. That tells me that a lot of people think it's good and you don't. Okay, but But something could be overrated and still incredible. Something could be overrated and terrible. Like, it tells me absolutely nothing. I've watched all of MHA many times. Many, many times. In fact, I just finished a rewatch of it, like, a couple days ago. I just finished my rewatch of everything up to season 5, you know? So I have thought about this show a lot. I've read the entire Vigilantes manga, the spin-off manga. I've read that entire thing from start to finish. It's a finished manga now. It was a pretty long manga, and I finished all of it. So I've got a pretty good grasp on all of the story except for what's to come, because I refuse to read the original manga because I enjoy the anime so much that I don't want to spoil that experience for myself. So I am very, very attached to these characters and to everything that's going on here. So when there's an episode like this where it's so many things coming together and so many things happening that in ways I expected, in ways I didn't, it's insane. I'm going to talk about Eraserhead first, because that's the biggest thing. So if he has lost his quirk, which in all likelihood he has, that changes things massively. So assuming this is the finished bullet, this is not one of the beta ones, because there were beta ones where it didn't completely erase a quirk, but I assume these are the ones that Shigaraki took from Overhaul when he was, you know, lying on the street. And those ones were the completed product. So this is a quirk, and I think before Shigaraki So, assuming that I understood the scene in a previous episode correctly, Shigaraki looked at the bullets and was like, man, most of these, like, got destroyed in the explosion or whatever. And so I think he maybe only had that one quirk erasing bullet left, and he used it, obviously, on the person whose quirk is hampering him the most, which is Eraserhead. Their entire plan revolved around Eraserhead. And it makes perfect sense, because Eraserhead's power is one of the most... like, it was one of the strongest in the series, and the only reason they can do certain things. So it is terrifying, him losing that power. That is terrifying, because one, they were all struggling against Shigaraki with zero powers. And by struggling, I mean they were maybe just winning. Just. Like, this much. And so now, but with him, with all his powers, I genuinely can't see how they're gonna win, you know? Like, he's stronger than All for One. He's stronger than anyone in this series so far. And he was, like, he was almost as strong as All for One without quirks. So, yeah, it is absolutely insane. But yeah, I can't see how they're gonna win this, but I feel, I mean, they've gotta, right? They can't just end the series with the world getting destroyed. So that's the crazy thing. But also, I mean, Eraserhead, like, his power, he has been used for so many missions because he is one of the most useful heroes out there. Like, that is, like, the most useful quirk in a villain, super villain society. And on top of that, he's supposed to be training Eri. And so we're in trouble until Eri, like, obviously... the whole point of training Eri, or one of the major parts of training Eri, was training her to be able to control her power enough that we can then use Eri's quirk to get the power that Lemillion had back. So, theoretically, once Eri is trained, they could also get Eraserhead's power back. And that's all well and good, except for the fact that Eraserhead is the one that they were going to use to train Eri to make sure she didn't go overboard. I don't know how they're going to do that now, because I think at the end of Season 5, and I had forgotten about this, but I just rewatched Season 5, as I said, but they went into, like, I think it was literally the last episode of Season 5, they saw Eri and she was like shivering and her horn was like reacting and she said it was itchy as well, which made me think of Shigaraki. But yeah, her quirk was activating basically and Hado was just like holding her, and Eraserhead said he's gonna start her training. But yeah, so, but he can't do that now. Like, he can't train her. So how else are they gonna train her? I have no idea. Are they just gonna have her hold on to Deku again, and he's just gonna have to keep destroying his body until she's able to? Oh my god, I have no idea. Anyway, the bits with Nana made me cry, because look, the thing about Nana Shimura is, like, we know a bit about her. We don't know a crazy amount about her, but the unfortunate thing is, she was doing what she thought was right for her family, because she didn't want her family to be involved in all the stuff she was doing, and she didn't want All for One to do what he definitely would do, which is find her family and use it against her. The problem is, he found her family. So what she ended up doing was creating a child that already was filled with so much hate and neglect and felt betrayed by his own mother. So much so that he raised a child that also, like, was in a pit of despair, was completely isolated and alone, and didn't feel like he fit into superhero society, which now has become Shigaraki. Like, it's so sad, because Nana was a great person, but that was an incredible mistake. Like, that was a major misstep, where she neglected her child and also helped to facilitate the greatest villain that we've seen in this world so far. Like, it is so horrifying and sad that happened, because she didn't want to do it either, so she made a sacrifice and it turned out for the worse, and that is heartbreaking. I feel like in these sorts of media, you know, superhero action media, when someone makes a sacrifice, it is generally for the better, you know? Like, no matter what, it will improve something, generally. you don't often see sacrifices that make things worse at the same time, you know? It's really, really heartbreaking. And finally, oh my god, I mean, there's so many sad moments at the end that the hype moment I almost forgot about, but the Kirishima and Mina moment is amazing. Because I, like, you know, that's awesome that Mina has this move that lets her shield herself. That's awesome on its own. And then as soon as he was like, "Everything is for my master," it triggered with me at the same time as Mina. I love that the show did that, where like at the exact same time as he said that line, both Mina and I had that thought, like, oh my god, the backstory. But for Mina, it was like, oh my god, this is the guy that I saw. For me, it was like, oh my god, this is why they're doing this with Mina. Like, this is why they're having her be the one to get through. And because, I mean, realistically, the author could write a situation where any one of the heroes had to be the final one to finish that, you know? But he specifically wrote it as Mina was the one to get through because he wanted this to happen. But then she loses it. And then Kirishima comes in, just like when Kirishima was afraid back then and Mina jumped in. Ah, oh, it's so brilliant. I love it. I love it. It shows their growth. It shows, like, you know, a vulnerability in Mina. I feel like we don't get many vulnerabilities in Mina. I feel like she's actually, I mean, like, we have weaknesses for her, for sure. She is like a little too loose and relaxed and stuff. And she doesn't have the same drive as some of her classmates, I feel like. She definitely wants to be a hero. She wants to work hard and save people. And she does jump in. Her instincts are amazing. But I feel like when it comes to like her actual resolve, it's not like as strong as like, you know, people like, you know, Deku's and Bakugo's. I mean, Todoroki's, the top students, obviously. But even, yeah, like I would say even like Kirishima and Kaminari and like maybe like Momo, Uraraka, like these people, we've seen them like really have these strong thoughts, you know, these they go deep into this hero mindset and like push themselves. We haven't really seen much of Mina pushing herself, rather we've just seen her doing her best and being okay with that. And I mean, I don't know if that's I don't think that's a conscious character flaw that Horikoshi wrote, but I think by the way she's written, that's just how she is. But it's nice to see an emotional vulnerability here, sort of like we saw when she first came across Jigendamaku and she cried because it was scary. But that was like I always saw that as like a relief cry, like, oh, that was scary, but it's over. But now, I mean, now this is like, I think it did affect her and it stuck with her all these years, you know? So that is crazy. But we've seen now Kirishima has grown to the point where he is terrified, but he's doing what Red Riot said, not Red Riot, Crimson Riot said, where Crimson Riot was like, of course I'm scared. Find me someone who isn't scared and I'll find you an idiot. Like that guy where basically he's like, yeah, I'm terrified too, but I'm not going to let that stop me from putting my life on the line. And he's, saves her. It's amazing. He gets that all done. That's awesome. Yeah, that is great. I talk about Kodai a lot. Yui Kodai. I know most people probably don't remember her character very much because she is in a couple episodes and she has a background role basically. I just have always liked her because I like her design. I think she's cute. And so like a character will stick in my head more if I really, really like their design. So that's why I remember her. That's why I think I remember her name is Yui Kodai. I think that's what it is. But anyway, she's the Class B student who can shrink and grow objects at will, you know? So I think she has to touch the object to do the size change, but she can, turn it back to its normal size, right? I don't think they used her power at all in this entire sequence, but I think it would have been useful for a couple things. I mean, you could use it to, just off the top of my head, right? His mouth, he's closing it. If you shrank the what's it called? The fertilizer. Nope. Tranquilizer. If you shrank the tranquilizer, it's this big, right? Like, let's say I've got pretty big hands and they have maybe smaller hands. So like, let's say that big. So it's that big a tranquilizer. You shrink it down, you know, you can get it to that big. If you just needed to get it into his mouth, I think you'd rather be throwing, but then like maybe it'd be caught by the wind. I don't know. I don't know how much this is going to be working, but if you did that, and then maybe do what you did in the battle and then give it to Poltergeist and make her send it flying in, I think you've got a better chance then, instead of throwing it, you know. I'm sure Poltergeist was already doing that, but she should have been doing it with Yui's one that she shrank, or shrink all of them, because I'm pretty sure she'd be able to shrink that many things, you know. They're only small things, and there's only, like, I don't know, 20, 30 of them. Yeah, shrink it down, and then once they're in their mouth, release, make it bigger, there we go. So yeah, anyway, I just thought that would have been like a plan that they could have had, but they never ended up doing it. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this video. Wow, I had a lot to talk about on that one. Please make sure to support the video, like, comment, subscribe, and go to my Patreon account for full-length early access exclusive videos. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.